Thank you, Ken Corlin. Thank you, Minister. I'm up here. I want to ask you, Minister, when Duodopa, which was approved for reimbursement in February 2020, will be sanctioned for use by patients who urgently need that medication. Now, Duodopa is manufactured by AbbVie, and I expect you know it has a number of manufacturing plants up and down the West Coast. And it does seem, Minister, that we're very good at manufacturing new medicines in Ireland, but we certainly lag behind when it comes to making those medicines available to patients. Now, this medicine has taken 26 months to go through the reimbursement process. The drugs group approved it for reimbursement in February, and 8 months later, we're still waiting for it to be sanctioned. Now, there was a big announcement in the budget with 50 million, an allocation in the budget for new medicines. And in fact, Minister Donnelly singled out Parkinson's when he was speaking about this extra budget allocation, and just to say that this drug is used to treat advanced Parkinson's when no other medicines will work. I know of a person who's in hospital. I won't say where, because I don't want in any way to maybe say anything that people might know who I'm speaking about. But this person cannot leave hospital. They're waiting. Every day is like a week. Every week is like a month. And they're now over a month in this hospital waiting for the go-ahead to get this drug. So, Minister, I'm hoping, really hoping, you'll have good news for me this evening, that at least you will be able to give me a date. Thank you.
Thank you, Deputy Harkin. Minister.
Thank you, Ken Corlin. Thank you, Deputy Harkin, for raising this important issue today and giving me the opportunity on behalf of Minister Donnelly to provide much clarity as possible on the availability and the reimbursement on Duodopa for patients with advanced Parkinson's disease. As the Deputy may know, the HSE has been given statutory responsibility for medicine pricing and reimbursement decisions under the Health Act 2013. The Act specifies that certain criteria for decision on whether the state will reimburse medicines, and the Minister for Health has no role in the statutory process. The HSE decision on which medicines are reimbursed by the taxpayer are made on objective scientific and economic grounds, including on the advice of the National Centre for Pharmaeconomics. The NCPE conducts assessments on behalf of the HSE. It then makes recommendations on reimbursement to assist the HSE in its decision making. The HSE strives to reach a decision on drug reimbursement in as timely a manner as possible. However, because of the significant monies involved, it must ensure that the best price is achieved, often leading to a protracted and deliberated process. On the 14th of June 2019, the NCPE completed an assessment of the drug for patients with advanced Parkinson's disease and recommended that it should not be considered for reimbursement unless its cost efficiency could be improved compared to other existing treatments. This recommendation is available to view on the NCPE website. Following this recommendation, the HSE entered into a lengthy pricing negotiation with the manufacturer. When these concluded, the reimbursement was formally considered by the HSE drug group over two meetings, and the second of which was held in February, which you have alluded to there, Deputy Harkin. The Minister wishes to make it clear to the Deputy that the drug was not approved for reimbursement in February of this year. Instead, it was at that time that the drugs group made a positive recommendation to the HSE executive management team. This was in the context of the recognised unmet need, the clinical evidence and its cost efficiency. The drug is one of a number of medicines with a significant budget impact awaiting a decision by the HSE executive management team. The HSE has yet to make a final decision on the specific reimbursement application, and the statutory process is still ongoing. However, Deputy will be aware, and you have mentioned it, the additional 50 million was allocated to the HSE in the budget 2021 to enable the approval of new medicines. Minister Donnelly understands that the reimbursement of the drug will be considered in that context.
Thank you, Minister Deputy Harkin.
Ken Corla, and thank you, Minister. Unfortunately, you didn't give me a timeline or a date, and it's very clear, you know, from my question and what I've said, that that's what this family are waiting for. This is a 26-month process. You point out to me quite rightly that it was the drugs group that made a positive recommendation last February. But what is the hold-up from there on in, especially since the Minister himself made all of this extra money available for new drugs, and he specifically he spoke about Parkinson's and drugs for Parkinson's. This family see other families able to access this drug. They know it works. They know it's the only thing that will work for their loved one, and they're glad to see other people receiving it, but they still wait. So, Minister, the Northwest Parkinson's Association and the Mayo Parkinson's Association are all waiting to hear what you have to say on this, because there is no other drug that will fit the bill. So can I ask you, please, to use your very best efforts, and I know you will, Minister, to try to speed up this process as much as possible. I have to say I'm disappointed, not for me, but for the person I know who's waiting and who's listening to this here tonight. I did honestly think that I might hear some positive news. So I leave it with you, Minister, and I would appreciate if you would come back to me as soon as you can. Thank you.
Minister, to conclude briefly.
All right. Deputy Harkin, I will take on board exactly what you said, and I will talk to Minister Donnelly about it. And yes, I have to compliment the wonderful work of the Parkinson's group. So when you've named Mayo and the North West, it would be remiss of me not to include Galway Parkinson's as well. But Minister Donnelly has on his note here to me that he hopes that the final decision on the reimbursement application concludes shortly for all concerned. And that is on his note. And I will follow up with the Minister on foot of what we have discussed here tonight and let the family know that. Thank you.
Thank you very much.